I'm called Jean-Jacques, coming from Rwanda, East Africa. My presentation today, I'm talking about the secondary school teachers' levels of integrating ICT tools into biology teaching and learning process. In this century, we have seen that ICT play a pivotal role in providing knowledge and skills needed for the 21st century generation, as it facilitates also communication among students and teachers. Also, it increases accessibility on teaching and learning resources. Therefore, to use ICT in education is viewed as one of the best methods for providing quality education, mainly in developing world. Among other countries, specifically, each school at both primary and secondary level differ a number of smart classrooms. Here, these smart classrooms, they are classroom equipped with all ICT tools, including computers, projectors, and the internet facilities, so that teachers can and the student can use it when they are in teaching and learning. Even if all these efforts are being made to make sure that the ICT is used, there is a need to understand how far teachers are implementing or are using these available tools in their profession. Again, in the literature, there have been no many researchers which have done on specific subject teachers, such as biology teachers, how they use these ICT tools. It is in that perspective that we formulate this research with the aim of exploring the extent to which Rwandan biology teachers integrate ICT and computer technologies into their teaching and learning process. So the research questions were, to what extent biology teachers use ICT tools in their profession, and also investigated the attitude and self-efficacy of biology teachers towards computers. And also, we investigated the difference which might exist on teachers' attitude and self-efficacy by their demographic data. And also, the last question were to investigate the challenge the teachers they face when they try to use these ICT tools in their profession. So they made the research methodology used. The research methodology used, we used descriptive research design using both quantitative and qualitative approach. And the research was carried on 54 biology teachers selected in two districts of eastern part of this country. And we collected data using interview protocol and also questionnaire developed by Christensen, and also we observed their recent plan, whether they have intention to use ICT tools when they are planning for their lesson. Then the procedure, we administered the questionnaire to teachers after being explained the purpose of the study. And later we analyze their lesson plans After, yes, then we, during that analysis, we use the SPSS, we use also in Vivo, descriptive statistics were the tools used to summarize this data along with the Winnie, Mann Winnie test and Kruskawari's test. The results shows that for the first research question, the extent to which biology teachers use computers in their profession, the result shows that 24% of the teachers, they reported that they use it daily, while 53% said that they used occasionally, but at least once per week. 63% of the teachers reported that they at least spend 1 to 3 hours using computer per week. Also, when it comes to sharing computer resources, 87% said that they can share computer resources using email, flash disk, or CD, DVD, to name few. Again, those who can access computer at home, they were 87%, and also 63% said that they can have internet at home, while 94% said that they can use internet computers to prepare lessons, and others the resource which they use to prepare lesson, the majority said that they download content from internet. The second research question was about teachers' attitude, but in summary, this data they shows that teachers' attitude were positive, and also for self-efficacy, the same, they were positive, and they believed that they are not scared by computers or by using computers. Others, they said that they can develop instructional materials using desktop publishing software applications. When we compare the attitude and self-efficacy by age of teachers by age, the result shows that there were no statistical significance between male and female, or the same in terms of their attitude and the self-efficacy, there was no difference. Again, this difference was not observed in terms of age, in terms of also experience with computers. Then the challenge which they face when they try to use this ICT, the majority of the challenge reported in the interview, they said that lack of time to prepare ICT-based materials. Again, there were some of them reported that they don't have enough adequate technological skills to use ICT. Again, also poor internet connection is one among the challenge they face, and also heavy workload, specifically for these biology teachers, always they are biology is always reported to be overloaded in terms of curriculum. Then about the skills which they wish to receive when a training was planned for them. Some they said that it is better if they learn how to teach using computers. Other reports that it will be better if they learn how to select good audiovisual materials from the internet, to search also subject on the internet, and also some wished to receive basic skills for using computers and other ICT materials. So this result shows that these teachers, they are ready to use computers and the ICT materials in the classroom or during the lesson delivery. And even if the time they spend is using this is short, maybe due to the fact that they require additional time to prepare these ICT materials, maybe one of the challenge they face, which is also reported in the literature. Again, teachers, these biology teachers reported that they use ICT tools in other activity apart from teaching and learning, such as preparation of lessons, exam, and maybe making lesson plans. This result also are supported from the literature. The attitude was positive, which is something good, and also similar to what is reported in the literature. And the majority of the teacher, they believe they can use computers and other ICT tools in their daily works. Among the challenge also, the challenge they reported also is, which is included to limited time to prepare and use ICT-based material, which is also reported in the literature. And the internet connection, which is slow sometimes, those are, and also lack of right skills and knowledge for teachers to use ICT are many challenges which are found in many parts of the world, specifically in the developing countries. Therefore, we believe that based on the findings, we can say that the teachers, they use their ICT and also they are ready to use them, but they use ICT less frequently due to limited technological skills and the time to prepare ICT tools. And we believe that in this context, there is a need of developing regular CPD courses for in-service teachers about the use of ICT in teaching and learning process. Thank you for your kind attention. If there is any question, we would like to welcome them. Thank you.